Hello, so today we are going to study about Hooke's law. To begin with, Hooke's law states that the extension of an elastic material is directly proportional to the force applied, provided the elastic limit is not exceeded. So to verify this law, we are going to carry out an experiment, and these are the parameters that we shall need. We shall need a retort stand, a meter rule, a scale pan, different masses, a spring, and a pointer. So the first thing, we clamp a meter rule onto this retort stand. Then we also put aside our spring together with the pointer. Then we mark the initial position, which is 47 centimeters. So our initial position is PO, which is 47 centimeters. Then we get a mass of 100 grams on a scale pan and add it here. The spring will extend. So our new position is 49 centimeters. So position 1 is 49 centimeters. So using position, the initial position and position 1, we shall have to find the extension. And the extension is represented by E, it's equal to P1 minus P0. So 49 minus 47 is 2 centimeters. We shall repeat the procedure using different masses, like 200 grams, 300 grams, 400, 500 grams. And after doing all that, we shall get their respective extensions by still getting the position after placing the mark and from subtracting it from the initial position. Then we shall tabulate our results in such a table. Initial position P0. 47 centimeters, and then add different masses in grams, our force in newtons, position 1 in centimeters, and then the extension. So our first mass is 100 grams. So to turn this into a force, we shall have to first turn the grams into kilograms. That we shall do by dividing 100 divided by 1000, and then to turn the kilogram into newtons, multiply by 10, because 1 kilogram is equivalent to 10 newtons. So we shall work that out. And we get 1 newton. And then our P1 is 49. Our extension is 2. The same thing for 200 grams, 300 grams, 400 grams, and so on. When we are done with our table, we shall plot a graph of force by extension, force in newtons, extension in centimeters. When we plot, we shall have to get a linear graph, and this shows that an increase in force causes an increase in extension, hence verifying Hooke's law that says that the extension of an elastic material is directly proportional to the force applied, provided the elastic limit is not exceeded.